In this video, we want to identify outliers in a set of data. If you're not sure what an outlier is, here's what they are. An outlier is an extremely high or extremely low value in the data set. Now, in addition to just being something really high or something low, you want to make sure that it satisfies the following criteria. If you want to find an outlier, it must be greater than Q3 plus 1.5 the interquartile range, or it must be lower than Q1 minus 1.5 times the interquartile range. This is making sure that it really is an extremely high value or extremely low value. You can see, though, that we need to compute a few different things like Q3 and Q1 and the interquartile range if we're going to properly identify one of these outliers. So let's look at some data and see how this works. In my data, I have a chart of maybe how many phone calls were received on any given day. So I got 10 phone calls on the first day, 12 phone calls on the second day, and so on and so forth. If I'm going to compute things like Q1, Q3, and the interquartile range, it's probably a good idea to take all of this data and write it out in order. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. All right, so you can see that when I list out my data like this, 22 does look like a pretty high value, and 10 looks like a fairly low value. To double check that, you know, one of these might be an outlier, or maybe both of them, let's go ahead and start breaking down our data to find Q1 and Q3. So I want to find the halfway point of my data, and I have 12 data points, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. So I need the mean of the first half and the mean of the second half. Let's see, the halfway point of the first half, let's call this Q1, and looks like that is equal to 11. Remember, you find that by adding 11 plus 11, dividing by 2. The mean of the second half, this would be 14 and a half. All right, now to find our interquartile range, we would end up subtracting these two values from one another. This would give us 3.5. All right, we have all of the information we need. Now we can figure out other values, so we can figure out outliers. So to look for an extremely high value, it must be larger than Q3, which is 14.5, plus 1.5 times the interquartile range, 3.5. And to find an extremely low value, I would take Q1, 11, and I would minus 1.5 times the interquartile range. Let's see what these equal. And 5.75. All right, so here's how this works. If I have any data points that are larger than 19.75, they're an outlier. And if I have any data points that are smaller than 5.75, those are outliers. Well, looking at all of our data, we can see that the 22 is definitely larger than 19.75, so it's definitely an outlier. Unfortunately, I have nothing less than 5.75, so I don't have any lower outliers. So this entire set of data only has one outlier, and it's just the 22. So it's definitely an extreme value. So remember that you got to find a few different bits of information first, but this is how you go about finding your outliers.